Hello and welcome to Let's Play Policenauts Blind, the English translation on the Sega Saturn. Just a few things before I get into everything. This was released, it was never officially released in English. There's another one of Hideo Kojima's games before Metal Gear Solid. So released on the Sega Saturn as well as the PlayStation 1, original PlayStation, and the 3DO, among a few other systems. Many thanks to the translation team at Policenauts.net, including Game Zelda, Facundo ARG, Saturn AR, Raising, Sky, Blade, Cloud, Mark Laidlaw, Cafe Alpha, El Duce, among others. So thank you very much for the translation, and it was also translated for the PS1, but there are additional features. Each of the releases really has something, I think, a little special to it. The PS1 release has an extra disc or two with the, like a glossary of subjects and characters and such. But on the Sega Saturn, it's all on one disc, so you don't have to switch the disc to, go into it. And I'm playing on the SSF Sega Saturn emulator. This is like kind of like Snatcher, which I just finished playing. It's an adventure game with shooting segments and stuff, although I heard that there are more of them and they're more varied, so I'm kind of not looking forward to that. It was really tough to control in the Sega Saturn, which I think might have been, you know, maybe easier with the actual Sega CD, but hopefully it's, you know, a little easier here. I play thoroughly, slowly, and I read all the things, so I'm going to be reading a lot. It's going to take us quite a while to just get off this screen. So I do read all the things, and if you don't like someone who reads all the things and talks a lot about stuff, I'm going to react to stuff, of course, so that you will not want to watch this. Just so you know. But I will not talk over the Japanese voice acting. The translations are text only. The Japanese voice acting, of course, is present, and I will not speak over him. So when he speaks, you might want to read the screen alongside him unless you can understand Japanese. And yeah, the opening theme. The do-do-do-do-do, that you can hear that in the beginning of Metal Gear Solid, the first Metal Gear Solid, when the, what do you call it, the, why can't I think of this, the Konami logo shows up. They play that, which is interesting. Anything else? I'm playing this blind, so I have not left this room. I just looked at a few items in this room, and there is, actually, if you, on the start screen where it says press start, if you don't do anything, it ends up going into like kind of a trailer, and I could see some characters, hear some lines, so that's kind of spoilery, so that's why I really haven't included that in my, previous video, the intro. I was going to, but I'm like, oh, it's kind of spoilery, and I kind of wish I hadn't seen it. I mean, it's very vague, but I think I caught a glimpse of the big baddie, or a baddie, and, certain events that happen, and people talking, and some action scenes, and such like that. So, yeah, I kind of wish I didn't see that, so. But anyway, please no spoilers, because, yeah. I'm playing blind, and I don't want to be spoiled, and spoiled enough by that trailer. It's nothing really that bad, so I might upload it as a separate upload when I'm done with this anyway. So anyway, you move around the screen. I don't know if I can get my mouse working as a mouse. I might try to do that for the next episode. So if you go outside the screen, you can go leave. I don't have anything to do outside. It's still early anyway. I'll wait here for that client to show. And then system, storage device. I use a RAM cartridge, which is a virtual RAM cartridge. And then, of course, load, save, quit. It tells you to turn off your Saturn. Cursor speed, I have it fastest. It's a good idea. The controls, default southpaw on one hand, sounds a little suspicious, but actually there was something with the Saturn, I think it was something with the Saturn games where the controller was designed in certain cases where you could use it with one hand, I guess. Hold your soda with the other or whatever else you feel like doing. No comment. And calibrate gun. That's if you have the light gun, I think it's called. I do not have, so. So we will look at things. And yeah. So stuff. Yeah, his gun. So it's gonna be a little awkward at first getting used to this. This is my gun, a Beretta 92F. Now that asterisk you see there means there's been a new item added to the glossary. I've had her since I was a cop. She's a bona fide recoil gun equipped with a laser sight. I use special 10-round magazines with armor-piercing rounds, but I don't carry, so I can go around shooting everything in sight. She's strictly for protection. Now, so if we go... If I hit start... Right, we go recent. So you can look at the stuff. This is from the, I don't know. I don't want to read all this stuff right now. I might go into this in an episode or two, just reading through the entries, which are probably going to take several episodes. The last handgun Beretta manufactured that uses gunpowder. A recoil gun, this is Jonathan Ingram's weapon of choice. He has modified his with a laser sight and uses special 10-round magazines with armor-piercing rounds. That's a shorter entry. Recoil gun. A gun that fires powder cartridges and utilizes a blowback, recoil gas, or Gatling action. Once used extensively on Earth, they are now collectively known as recoil guns because when fired in zero gravity, the recoil launches the user backwards. This type of gun has fallen out of use as space expansion has progressed, as the recoil it produces cannot be suppressed in zero gravity. It is said that only collectors still purchase them. Furthermore, as recoil guns leave a traceable rifling mark on the bullets they fire, whereas lift guns do not, they have become unpopular even among criminals. The production of powder cartridges used exclusively with recoil guns has also fallen dramatically, and like bent cigarettes, they are only available through special offer. Jonathan Ingram's Beretta 92F is classified as a recoil gun. Oh, old L.A. Acronym for Old Los Angeles. New Los Angeles is located to the north of OLA, or LA as it existed until the early 21st century. As a result of the city's economic downturn, even its iconic rail system has been abandoned. It didn't mention negotiator. Someone who negotiates with kidnappers for the release of other of their hostages. Some specialize in negotiating, but most negotiators also work as private investigators. Although half of his work involves negotiating, Jonathan Ingram is a traditional private investigator as well. Let's go on to EMPS. He mentioned that. Acronym for extra vehicular mobility police suit. Okay, so that was his accent with the suit, as we saw in the intro. A mobile police suit for use both inside and outside space colonies jointly developed by Tokugawa Heavy Industries and BCP, originally designed for tasks like preserving order and performing maintenance work outside beyond coast. Its bilateral master-slave manipulator allows for a unrestricted 7 degrees of freedom, just like the human body, and it also does not contain any singular points. It is a machine with its own sensory feedback, said to feel no different from wearing a spacesuit, created by combining advanced operations robotics technology with feedback functions applied from VR and tele-existence? Having a human pilot compensate for a robot's cognizance time lag has made efficient advanced operations of reality. EMPS are equipped with various sensors and communication systems as well as emergency rations. The Yuri model, piloted by astronaut Jonathan Ingram during a test spacewalk, was an early EMPS prototype developed as a successor to devices such as the Manned Maneuvering Unit and the Extravehicular Mobility Unit. Numerous improvements have since been made by incorporating technology from planetary exploration probes and other advanced operations robots, the results of which include the Goddard model, the primary EMPS in use by BCP, the Oberth model, an EMPS used for mining on the moon, and the Von Braun military EMPS prototype. Tokugawa Heavy Industries has a monopoly on all EMPS development, production, and maintenance. That's against the law, Buster. I guess it may be another cyberpunk-type environment. Monopolies and such. Policenauts. Might as well just finish reading these. The Outer Space Police Force established to provide security for those moving to beyond coast during the third wave of immigration, the first wave of general immigration, in 2013. Its purpose was also to lay the foundation for a permanent police presence on the colony. Police officers from around the world were recruited for the program in 2010. Officers with the skills required to become astronauts and act as a police unit on mankind's first space colony. 5 were chosen out of the initial selection pool and put through 3 years of intense training. Okay, these are the people we saw in the intro, watching on, and including our main protagonist here. Astronaut Gates Becker from Scotland Yard in the United Kingdom. Astronaut Joseph Sadaoki Tokugawa. Oh, is he the same one as that company? Tokugawa. From the Tokyo Metropolitan Police Department in Japan. So Tokugawa is also the one who makes the suits then. And maintains them, etc. Tokugawa, right? I'm going to check that again. Astronaut Salvatore Toscanini from the NYPD in the United States. And also from the United States, astronauts Jonathan Ingram and Ed Brown from the LAPD. Becoming astronauts with police authority, they were regarded throughout the world as symbols of peace in outer space and became the focus of a global media frenzy. Really? Additionally, they are credited with revamping the image of space expansion, which has often been cast in a negative light. Also known as the original COPS, as they were reminiscent of Project Mercury's original 7. And finally, Beyond Coast. Mankind's first space colony completed in 2010. The first and only O'Neill colony, shaped like a cylinder, has a population of 1 million. Orbits around the Lagrangian point L5, one of the two most stable gravitational areas around Earth in relation to Earth and the Moon, the other being L4. Is this true? Really? Never heard of that. The circle it forms with the Moon and two of the other Lagrangian points, likened to the shore of the vast ocean of outer space, inspire the colony's name. Makes a full rotation every 2 minutes, creating artificial gravity nearly equal to 1G. Has 3 mirrors for gathering solar rays and can produce the effect of night by closing them for eight hours. The mirrors also serve as radiation shields. The other reason behind the colony's name is its climate is based on that of the west coast of the United States. Its energy needs are met by solar energy stations located outside the colony in addition to nuclear reactors. The colony is approximately 4 miles in diameter and 20 miles long. The total surface area of any of its 3 surface stripes is 56 square miles. The combined 3.5-mile thickness of the cylinder and its atmosphere help reduce the cosmic radiation gathered by the mirrors to 0.5 rem year-round. It is also equipped with shields that automatically lower during periods of intense radiation bombardment. Parts of the colony's outer walls and mirrors have deteriorated with age. The ISPA has devised a plan to replace all of the colony's parts over the next 10 years. Alright, so you can go into categories, alphabetical, and yeah, it's insane. Now, if you click on things repeatedly, you get different explanations sometimes, or further explanation. I doubt anyone else uses this kind of gun in the 21st century and everything. With the birth of the colony age, nearly all guns are now lift guns. People don't use recoil guns in weightless environments for obvious reasons, but her, she's a part of me. Now, I could go look up lift guns, but we'll never get out of this room. 3 days I have to go all the way to the edge of town to order the rounds, or these days, sorry. His badge. This is a replica of the badge I had in LAPD. Sure does take me back. There's a picture from those days on the wall. It's a supposed LAPD police badge. This is ancient history now. Meaningless decoration, really. This is an investigation report to a client, though I haven't gotten very far with it. It was another child kidnapping, but my negotiations with the kidnappers failed. I couldn't save the child. He's probably already been cut apart and his organs trafficked to buyers. Sorry, kid. That's horrible. It's an investigation report I'm working on. You hate to see a case end like this. Alright, we got cigarettes. These are Moslems, the only cigarettes in the world that still give off secondary smoke. I don't like the pure bent cigarettes you get today. These are mixed cigarettes, part conventional, part bent. Bent cigarettes are cigarettes that don't produce any secondary smoke, which you light simply by breaking off the end. I say a light, but there's no actual fire involved. They work off a chemical reaction, and even the leaves are specially processed. They don't give off any smoke or ash and make a room more pleasant, but they're not my thing. The only brand I touch now is Moslems. You can still light a Moslem by breaking off the end, but using a lighter adds to the flavor. They give off a little smoke and ash, though not as much as the real ones did. Everything else is like sucking air, as far as I'm concerned. They only sell them through direct order now, so they aren't as easy to get a hold of as before. I'm down to my last pack. Light. I'll hold off for now. I just had one a few minutes ago. Besides, I'm running low as it is. It's a beer can. It's empty. They used to use aluminum for cans before, but these ones are made from biodegradable plastic. Almost all containers are made from biodegradable plastic nowadays. A lot of old farmland is now used to let these things decompose. Empty beer can. I can't drink. Oh, this one is not empty. It's a half-empty can of beer. The only beer most people can afford anymore is this imitation beer. Sucks knowing how good the real thing is. Nothing like imitation beer. Drink? Guess I'll have some before it gets warm. Ah, nothing but bad memories. May as well finish it. I honestly thought it couldn't get any worse than space food, but there you go. This is an ashtray I stumbled across at an antique store. It wasn't easy finding one of these. You don't need an ashtray for bent cigarettes, after all. The butts are starting to overflow. I guess I should empty it. I should probably clean out all the butts at some point. Perhaps you should. Now, I got some photos here. Oh, he's got the lighter. Let me look at the lighter. Let me just finish off this stuff here. This is a Brady oil lighter. They're the manufacturer of the only lighter still in production. You don't need lighters or matches for today's bent cigarettes. If anyone else saw this, they'd just laugh and tell me to stop living in the past. It's my Brady lighter. Okay. This is a photo of me and Lorraine at Lucas World. Don't read about
Lorraine.
Lucas World.
Autumn wife.
Autumn wife.
Yeah. それも過去のことだ。 俺があの事故を起こした後、ビヨンドで再婚したらしい。今では他人のワイフだ。日本人とアメリカ人との二世。あいつにはどこか神秘的なところがあった。Mysterious,
huh? You hear the theme play again. Yeah, really sad, huh? She just moved on. Now the thing is you can see in the intro he flew away, right? And or kind of was flung away into the void of space. And but then they found him use a welding torch, or not a cutter or something like that, to, you know, open. It looks like he was in some kind of capsule, and inside was him in his spacesuit. And apparently in some kind of suspended animation, because he looks about the same as he did when he, you know, was flung away into space. everyone else has aged. He would normally be about 50, I think. So, and you can even look at individual people and items in photos. I was a cop fresh out of the academy. Look at us, young and in love. Lorraine was a student at UCLA. We met after her place got broken into. She was so naive, the things she'd do sometimes. December 24th, 2008. This was our first Christmas together. I've still got the watch she gave me. It was one of those radio-controlled types. It was state-of-the-art for the time. Still hard to believe it's been over 30 years. Alright, so we got another photo here. This is me and Lorraine on our wedding day. I was still a cop here in L.A. Lorraine dropped out of UCLA after we got engaged. I remember discovering right before the ceremony that my rental tux didn't fit. I originally had a black tuxedo. In those days, my life revolved around my job and Lorraine. That bow tie. The flowers. Lorraine had this friend at a flower shop arrange her bouquet. If I remember right, Lorraine threw the bouquet right after this was taken. I still don't know how Ed ended up catching it. Oh, his friend. Ed's in a couple pictures on the wall. How about this flower? Just wonder how many things we can look at. Nope, it's just him. Is that... Oh, I thought there was someone behind her, but that's like part of her dress, I think. Lorraine was like an angel in her wedding dress. I still wear my wedding ring. Mwah. So there's no one behind her, right? It kind of looked like someone's standing back there, but it's part of her dress. Okay. Now, what is this? A cartridge here? I got... Oh, a pen. I got this pen when I was at LAPD. The mayor gave it to me along with the award on the wall. It was a pretty nice pen for the time. As you could expect from something this old, it started showing some wear and tear a while ago. This is a piece of paper with information on a client. I've been asked to look for their 4-year-old son. These are the only kinds of cases I've been getting lately. You just don't see many ransom kidnapping nowadays. It's safer for the kidnappers to quickly sell off the victim's organs to organ buyers, and they're guaranteed to see a return that way, too. Got a bad feeling about this one. It's a note related to a case I'm working. Is that the same case on the papers under his badge? It's a crumpled up piece of paper. This is a note from an old case. I'm not sure when it was. I had it stuck to the phone. My desk is a total mess, come to think of it. It'd be nice if I could hire an assistant or something, but it doesn't look like anyone's up for working at a place like this. Matt, you couldn't afford it. I've had a help wanted sign posted by the entrance to the building for quite some time, but no takers.
Really?
The client did a disappearing act on me. It happens a lot in this city. Okay, so we got a video phone here. This is a video phone with a built-in printer, though I've disabled outgoing video. Most of my cases come in over the phone. Clients don't particularly like meeting up in person. I'm way behind on my bill. I keep expecting it to get cut off any day now, so you want to hire an assistant. But you can't afford to pay your phone bill, or video phone bill, or whatever. Play messages. I should check the machine. Maybe there's a call from someone with a case. Who leaves a message at a wrong number? Still no cases. Let's see what the next one says.
くそ。仕事の依頼電話はないか?
When's someone gonna call with an actual case?
そうだ。俺はしけてる。分かってるさ。くそ。仕事の依頼電話はないか。
So it's funny, you might think, what is the Japanese word for lame-o? But this is not a one-to-one translation, this is a localization, which I actually just recently learned what the difference is. Translation is literally translating, and I guess rearranging the words around, you know, using, for the most part, most of the original words, you know, as translated. A localization adds, like, flavor to it. So he's in L.A., so his, you know, mannerisms and the way he speaks is localized to, you know, something approaching American English, but, yeah. I guess when this was first translated, people use lame-o, but, I don't know. I never heard many people use the word lame-o, but maybe that's his own individual well, that's her individual style, I guess. Whoever he was supposed to meet. So let's hear any more messages. Oops.
ヘボ探偵か。クソ。仕事の依頼電話はないか。
That's how you say damn it. クソ。Something like that. No. But you can learn how to say some words in Japanese just by playing through this game and paying attention. It's very interesting. Let's see what the next one says.
聞こえるか。モルソンだが、オタクとの取引はなかったことにしてくれ。じゃあな。
また依頼人に逃げられたか。くそ。仕事の依頼電話はないか。間違い電話とはバカにしてる。やっぱり事件の依頼は入ってないか。
入ってないか。Still no cases.It sounds like something messed up with his voice machine there. That's it? I see the water company hasn't forgotten about me either. It's been nothing but junk lately. Okay, so we've got stuff on the wall. Anything else on the desk to look at? Crumpled up beer cans. What is this on the edge? Is this anything?No, I guess not. Right. A single cigarette here, no. Alright. Let's... How about look out the window? These are some Venetian blinds I found at an antique store. I don't like the adjustable glass you get today. I put them up so you can't see inside the office from outside. This is a mixed building. You never know who's going to show up.Open? I'm probably better leaving them closed. God knows there's plenty of guys who'd love to take a shot at me. Alright, so let's look at these photos. You know what? What is this thing, actually? I think I'm gonna save the photos for last, actually. We don't have more to go. This is a model of Beyond. Ed made it for me. Ed's in a couple pictures on the wall.These cabinets are filled with information on past cases and clients. They're not exactly a pleasant read, but the papers inside are worth their weight in gold. It's a filing cabinet. I really need to get these organized. Maybe I'll try putting a job ad in the paper. I'm sick of looking at papers. I don't feel like opening it right now. I'm very insistent. All right, same here, I guess. These are books from the 20th century found in an antique media store. From the days when a book meant a real book, not software. These go for a pretty penny in this day and age. They're all mystery novels, actually. Lorraine's taste must have rubbed off on me. Well, you are a detective. Mystery is your thing. Alright, what about this here? Is this a picture? No, I don't want to do either of those. This leads to the building's fire escape. You always gotta make sure your ass is covered with good old Plan B in this line of work. This is a picture from when I was in LAPD. Me and my partner Ed were always together. So he was the one who seemed to be yelling the loudest when, or the most alarmed when Jonathan was spiraling away in his spacesuit.
Edo Brown. 俺の人生で最も信用できる親友であり、良きパートナーだ。
That badge on my desk is a replica of the one I had then. I was in narcotics at the time. I was reckless, with a pretty short fuse. I've carried my Beretta since then. My life felt so complete. Look at me, full of confidence. I'm like a totally different person. Me and Ed had been good friends since the academy. We were a well-known team in narcotics. Ed was in the bomb squad before he joined narcotics. There was a lot of terrorist activity back then. We stayed close when we were Policenauts, too. I haven't seen him since my accident. Maybe I'll give Ed another call if my next case turns out well. And the date? March 12th, 2010. Me and Lorraine were a happy husband and wife. So when's this client gonna show up? This photo was taken to commemorate the selection of the Policenauts. So there's the five. Ed up top left, and then Jonathan on the bottom left. That's Salvatore, I think, next to Ed on top. And from NYPD, I think, and the other two, I'm not sure of. I think I have it wrong. I think Salvatore is from... Where are they from? I know there's two from... I know Ed Brown and Jonathan are from LAPD. And Salvatore, I forget the last name, Italian name, he was from NYPD. And then there was another Japanese... Man, I'm guessing is the one in the middle. And I forget the last. Five officers out of all the world's police organizations were chosen and trained. Well, we can look at them once I get past this. We were called the original cops after Project Mercury's original seven. We're wearing ejection escape suits here. These are obsolete now. Back then, everyone thought the orange-colored suits were cool. Okay, so who is this again? I was right. That's Salvatore Toscanini. He came from NYPD. Apparently he resigned from Beyond Coast Police over 10 years or so ago. Salvatore was a bit of an oddball. I never could put my finger on it, but there was just something about him. Sort of guy you don't easily forget, anyway. Now, who sabotaged his suit? Because you saw in the intro someone loosened a screw, and that's all it took. Of course, that might have been just part of whatever sabotage operation was going on. Okay, so Ed Brown. That's Ed. He was chosen out of LAPD along with me. He looks thinner here compared to the LAPD picture. Ed's still on Beyond, as far as I know. Myself. I was absolutely ecstatic, but Lorraine, she was against me going to space. Then when I went to Mars, that was when we started to drift apart. After this was taken, I left Lorraine behind and moved to Beyond. Never should have done it, man. Okay, so this is Joseph Sadayaki Tokugawa. He came from the Tokyo Metropolitan Police Department in Japan. He's now the head of the Tokugawa Group. Sadayaki could be an intimidating dude at times. Maybe he is the baddie. Gates Becker, right. From the Scotland Yard in the UK, right, okay. I heard he's risen pretty high up through the ranks of Beyond Coast Police. Gates had a real passion for justice. He was always the leader. Well, I guess you could move up because you got one missing. There's only three other people. And one of them left, right? Okay, so that's all the people. How about this? This one's framed. I was given this award by the mayor back when I was a cop. Me and Ed were a well-known team in LAPD. This is the only award I've ever received for anything. The chief nominated the two of us for the Policenauts thanks to this case. Okay, we've got some other things here. This is a newspaper article written at the time of Beyond Coast's completion. This is a picture of Beyond Coast right after it was completed. The only thing they hadn't finished was the agricultural ring. That model Ed made for me is supposed to be this. Huh. He's going to tell me what the text reads here. The headline reads, Long Envisioned Colony Complete. New Era for Mankind. I'll read some of the article. Basic construction of the world's first outer space colony, Beyond Coast, underway for several years near Lagrangian Point L5, was completed yesterday. The first wave of specialized immigration will consist mostly of scientists and engineers who will spend 14 months performing checks and gathering data. Immigration is scheduled to be open to the general public in 3 years' time. Beyond's position is shown in the diagram to the left. About this part. This is all the same. Here they point out Beyond's location in space. It's in an orbit around the L5 Lagrangian point. It's the red dot. Same. Yeah. Hello?
今日は運がいい。こんな早い時間に客が来るとは。どうぞ。鍵はかかっていない。ジョナサン。久しぶり。
Lorraine?